Alrighty, good evening, everybody. How is everybody doing tonight? Well, look, if you could see, we are here tonight for the Showtime Winston Cup Classic Series, and this is going to be at Sonoma Raceway, the road course here tonight in the 87 Cup cars. So we're going to be in a treat for tonight because I actually went on to the track here a couple days ago just ahead to test this out on these cars. And you could see, it's going to be a little hard to see, but you could see cars everywhere on the track. And this is where it's going to be, I think it's going to be more of a bumper car going off track type of night because these cars are tricky to handle. You can easily go off the track and go for a ride. So let's go on board with a couple of guys after in a second, but let's go over the track real quick here at Sonoma. Sonoma is about 1.964 miles long, and there are 10 turns here tonight, so it's going to be a little bit different than what we're used to, just four turns compared to 10. And the weather for tonight, 74 degrees outside and 94 degrees on the track with a 3 mile per hour wind, with that north wind. No clouds. It's going to be completely sunny here tonight. So that's going to be one heck of a weather. So with 10 minutes left here, almost just over 10 minutes, let's see. Tommy Kelly, your fastest driver here tonight. And that number 62. Preston Puryear in second, Timothy Wortman in third, and Jared Rashawn in fourth, and Ken in fifth. That'll be rounding your top five. But you know what we're going to do? We're going to ride on board with Tommy Kelly. Let's ride on board with him for a lap here because he's going to be coming up to the finish line. And we'll just show you what it looks like as for a driver. You can see they're just fighting these things. You see Ken right there in the 43 spun around. Very easy to do. Coming down the hill right into the next corner. Well, gets it sideways. This is what we were talking about. It's gonna be very easy. I think we're gonna see maybe see everybody do this tonight. All right, who else is out there? We're watching Preston just whipping around the corners in the S's. Timothy Wortman coming in the S's now. We've seen him. That's who was right in front of Tommy Kelly there for a moment. Jared Wishon sitting in pit road. Ken, I think he's going into the S's now. So we'll get some interviews in and see what's going on out here. So let's see if we can pull up Ken if he's out here tonight. And he is. Let's pull Ken down here. Hey, Ken, this is Brandon No Lift. You got a copy?
Yes, sir. How are you doing tonight?
I'm doing all right. How are you?
It's getting better. I've got some practice Monday night, some practice earlier tonight, so I'm not. I'm here just to finish and get some points. I'm not going to push it.
All right, Willie might see you tonight on that drag strip down there at the end of the night.
Sorry, my spotter spoke up. What would you say?
No, you're all good. Are we going to see you at that drag strip down there by pit road at the end of the night?
We'll see.
I feel like we're going to see a couple of drivers at the end of the night all along.
Oh, man, this is true.
Yeah, because usually when he broadcasts, I broadcast at the same time.
So he never gets to see what you're seeing, huh?
Exactly, or I don't see, get to see what he's seeing.
Yeah, this is true. This is true. Okay, hold on. You don't have to be lonely at farmersonly.com. City folk just don't get it. I hope that meant action.
Oh, that was beautiful.
I'm glad. I'm glad.
Oh, but I was right. Robbie just did say, no, I won't be here. I have to broadcast. So we appreciate you doing it a little early for us.
Yeah, absolutely. No problem.
Keeping us a little entertainment before we go racing here at
Sonoma. Before we get going. That's right.
Yeah. Well, why haven't you put a time in yet? We see you right now still trying to figure it out.
If I can make the line right here, I should be able to get it. Ah, I made the line. Nice.
Good job.
All right. Thanks, man.
Well, you got Uncle Kenny laughing out there and Robbie just excited. Yes!
Oh. Glad I can entertain the masses with Kermit.
Well, you know, I bet you Robbie right now, I guarantee you, Robbie, I bet you misses this. Be able to interview you. We got to get Robbie up here one day if he's ever has a break, just be able to talk to you.
I think that'd be cool. Get to hear Robbie again. Robbie out here entertaining the masses.
I do miss Robbie's voice out there.
So do I.
Well, buddy, good luck. It looks like you're P2 right now with a 119.
Yeah. Even with the car a little bit damaged, the car felt good getting through everything. I kind of took a few corners easy. So hopefully we got something for Tommy tonight. He's going to be fast again.
I think the biggest key for tonight, though, is staying on the track. I believe, you know, I think we're going to see somebody that we really don't talk about much be able to do, if as long as they can stay on track, they have something.
Oh, yeah. Tonight's all about consistency and keeping your car in one piece. If you can keep it on track and in one piece and keep consistent lap times coming, you're going to be gold. Excuse me, golden. So, like I said, it's just a matter of consistency tonight. All road courses are just calm and smooth on the wheel, calm and smooth on the throttle.
Definitely. Well, Robbie out there, thank you, Zachy Poo, and no one wants to hear Robbie.
Oh. Yeah, Robbie, don't do that to yourself.
You can't beat yourself up, Robbie. Well, Zach, where's all your team? Where's your teammates?
Well, we got Jared out here. Jared's out here. He's running P3 right now, man. He's got a P3 time up there on the board. We got Jared.
He's P3, but the issue is I don't have a chance to pull him up here.
Yeah, I think his Discord's having some trouble. I don't know if he's able to get in or not, so I think I don't know exactly what he's gonna do, but I think his Discord's having some trouble.
Gotcha. Well, maybe I'll hop in TeamSpeak and get him up here.
Hey, I mean, that could be a possibility.
Definitely. Well, Zach, I'll talk to you a little bit. Good luck out there. Let's see what you can give these guys. I know you know road courses are one of your things, so let's see if you can do it.
Hey, buddy, I appreciate that. Thank you.
Yeah, good luck.
Thank you, buddy.
All right, it's Zach lingering there. Like Robbie says, Zachy Boo. Y'all be good. I'm off to get ready for the broadcast. Have a good broadcast, Brandon. And Zach, go win this. All right, Robbie, good luck out there for your broadcast, bud. Appreciate you tuning in, and good to hear from you. And we definitely all, you know, even look at Uncle Kenny saying, sure we do. We all like hearing your voice. All right, so it looks like, 2 minutes left? 2 minutes and 30 seconds left to qualifying. Timothy right now, let's see where he's at on track. So right now, Timothy getting ready to put his time in. So Tommy Kelly's your pole sitter right now with a 1 minute 19 seconds. And then got Zach lingering in second with a minute 19.5, where Tommy was at 0.8. No, wait, I lied. 0.0. Sorry. 0.0. Oh, right now, who's in third? I think that was Jared Rashawn. And fourth place is Preston Purrier. So you know what we're going to do? We're going to pull up TeamSpeak. See if, because I know Jared said his Discord is messing up. We'll pull, see how he's doing for a P3. Marshall with a P7 right now. Look at you going, Marshall. Doing good out there. Oh, we're 80. Oh, that is, I forgot to see. I'm sorry, Thomas out there. Remember me from Twitch? I do remember you, Thomas. Good to see you, buddy. Thanks for tuning in. On the YouTube side of things. Oh, let's see if I can pull him up here.
Channel switched. User was moved to your channel.
Oh, Jared Washon, this is Brandon O'Lift. You got a copy?
I got you.
All right, getting a little issues on probably Discord, I hear, but look at you getting yourself in P3.
Yeah, I kind of wasn't expecting it, because I don't think I'll be here for the full race. So to start up here, I don't know if I want to be up here or not.
Why won't you be here for the full race?
I think AFIX at 10 o'clock is calling my name at Talladega.
Oh, you want to get some Talladega action, huh?
Oh, yeah. probably going to die, but we might try.
What happens if you're leading there and then it's like 9:55? You're going to take that lead, just pull it over, and then go race?
I believe my brakes will fail around 9:50. So, you know, we got the button and the timer set, so they're just going to fall apart on me.
Oh, jeez. Well, buddy, good luck, and hopefully we can see you finish this thing off, but I guess I understand.
Maybe. We'll see how it goes, but I don't know. I just want to go run some Talladega.
Well, when you get a second, though, you got to watch, once we're done, you got to watch the beginning of the stream when I was talking to Mr. Zachy Poo. Robbie's out there in the chat. Guess what Zach's saying?
Oh, no.
Farmers only in the Kermit.
Ooh.
So you got to go back and watch that after the show. So when I throw you back down there, you got to ask him how that went.
That's usually a winning movie, doesn't it, in qualifying?
Well, Robbie had the broadcast, so, you know, that was, I had to have him do it before Robbie left.
Now I better go win, or he's going to ruin the good vibes from it.
Right. Well, all right, buddy, good luck out there. We'll talk to you a little bit later.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
User was moved out of your channel.
Alrighty, Zach. Or, I mean, Jared was shown there. There we go, get everything situated. So, our pole sitter, though, let's go through our grid real quick. Tommy Kelly, Zach Linger in row one. Row two is going to be Jared Washon and Preston Purrier. Row three, Joshua Battles and Ed Boyles. Row four, Marshall Layton and Wade Palmer. Row five, Charles Stevens and Jimmy Absher. And then row six is going to be Pete Woodrum. So, that's everybody that was able to qualify here tonight. Alrighty. Oh, Tommy Kelly. Let's see if I can get him up here real quick. Oh, where is he at, Richard? Yeah, he's in Richard Childress. Let's pull him down. Hey, Tommy. This is Brandon. You got a copy?
Yes, sir. I got you.
Alright. Look at you here tonight. Man, you're fastest during practice. Now fastest during the qualifying. Getting the pole here tonight. You got a really fast car, and you got this track figured out.
Yeah, I hope I do anyway. Put a lot of effort into this one. This was the track that I circled when I saw the schedule and wanted to. This is the one that I wanted to win, so we'll see what we can do.
Well, I wish you luck, and, you know, let's see what you can do. I know you man, week in, week out, you've been having some competition. So how you feeling though, be able to have some competition up there battling you these past couple of weeks?
I'm loving it. It's no fun to race if you're just winning every week. You always got to have a competition to make it fun.
Definitely. Well, I wish you luck. Let's see if you can keep that 85 behind you, get a good restart here, and the biggest key is keeping that thing on track.
Yeah, we'll see what we can do here.
Alrighty. Well, good luck. Don't mow any grass, because the race officials did pretty good out there. Well, that dead grass, I should say. So let's see, keep that front grill pretty clean.
Thank you. I'll try.
Alrighty. Good luck.
Thanks.
Alrighty. Tommy Kelly there. Alrighty. We're going through. We got that Porsche pace car out there, and see everybody trying to catch up here. I believe we don't have any cautions tonight. I think it's just a local cautions, unless there's a big one in, the admins do throw. That's the only way there will be. But we got 40 laps we're going to be doing tonight here at the road course. Now that's where it's going to be tricky. Alrighty. Great group of guys getting ready to have some fun for the first time of the night. I know a lot of them did not really look forward to this race, so we're coming up to the last corner, that sharp corner. Are we going to see any cars at the end of the race be a Tony Stewart and get that back in up on those tire barriers? We'll have to see. We'll have to keep an eye on this corner. Here we go. They're getting all lined up. Tommy Kelly, your leader. Zach lingering in second, getting ready to come to the line. The green flag is waving for the first time of the night. Great restart by Tommy Kelly going into turn one here in just a moment. I believe that's turn one. My corners are all going to be screwed up here tonight. Great. Look at that. He is pulled away from Zach Linger. Jared Wishon now into third place. In fourth, it's going to be Preston Purrier. Brandon hitting up there. Good luck, boys, sitting this one out. Oh, what the heck, Brandon? You don't want to have a loosey-goosey car out there? I don't blame you. Don't blame me at all. But you can see how red those rotors are getting, though. Already getting red, and they're not even completed a full lap yet. Coming into the S's here right now. Oh, smoke just a flying. Crepty hamster. Oh, road course. Good to see you out there. I haven't heard you from you for a little bit, bud. Good to see you, though. All right, look at them coming to that last corner, that sharp, sharp corner. Locking it up. Josh Battles is doing. Oh, the 15 going wide. Preston Burrier almost into the wall. You see the 1, 2, 3 a little far away. Bro, I'm going to send you the new golf glove I got. Alrighty, bud. I'm kind of scared to see how much that golf glove, the golf glove cost you. No road course racing for this guy, but I'm watching my guys do it. Definitely. You can see Marshall coming to the line now. I believe he must have spun out or went off track. Let's see. Actually, you know what we can do is I have something I can tell you when people come out, go off track. Kind of a cool little feature. Hey, he's getting off track now. Right now, currently in 15th, but Jared Wishon and Zach Lingren. You can see Zach's taking the lead up to first place. Jared Wishon in second. Tommy Kelly in third. I believe, I was trying to see if Tommy Kelly went off there. I'm at Pixel. I know what you're saying, Grumpy Hamster. All right, let's look at these gloves. Oh, those are cool, bud. Definitely cool. So 1 and 2 still, and I've noticed Zach Linger and Jared Wishon before at other road courses in different cars. They're always battling very close together. So we're going to see them doing that again. Let's see if Thomas Kelly will be able to catch up to these guys, though, with 38 laps to go. Pressed, oh, wheel hopping, going with the number 11 there, Joshua Battles. You see Ed Boyles, oh, going off track. Woo, woo. Timothy Wortman also there. Oh, wheel hopping in a farther back. That's going to be Wade Palmer. I kind of like watching that corner. Everybody's having some interesting times there. Jimmy Abisher there. Charles off track in the double O. Stewart also went off track that time by. I want to see someone smash into the wall, LOL. Here at Sonoma, you might see it. Oh, Zach getting a little wide there. He's definitely doing a great job. You can see Wade Palmer now going in. Watching Stewart here in the 28. He's got the number 5, Jimmy, right behind him. Getting ready to come into the last corner. Marshall right now currently in 14th coming to that last corner. And that Wheaties number 9. Go back up front, though. So Zach Lingren looking really well so far this time at this moment. He's led out there 4 laps so far. And how many, my biggest question, how many laps can you go on these tires in the field, though? That's going to be the question of the night. Let's go a little bit further back, though. Let's kind of watch around. I love watching, see where everybody's at. Charles also went off the road again. Charles is just having a rough time out here on track in that double O. Up on the curb. That's where he flipped it upside down earlier during practice. Wade Palmer went off track there. I heard somebody hit the wall pretty hard, though. So right now, Jared Michon 1.3 seconds back. Tommy Kelly 4.2. Preston's 9.8. And Joshua 11.8. That's your top five here. Here's Zach Lingren still going back up. Fastest lap is going to be held by Zach, 120.327. Jared Michon still sticking with him pretty well here. Preston right now in fourth, coming around that last corner, coming to the line here in just a moment. Joshua Battle's coming out of the corner too. Let's go see where 43 of Ken is here. On board with the Coca-Cola coming out of the corner. Back here in the S's, on board with Jimmy Absher. Right in front of him, that's going to be Wade Palmer. Wade's trying to battle out with the 28. Great battle going on right in front. This is for 12th, 13th, and 14th place. Looks like Wade takes over this. Oh, goes too wide in the corner. Oh, getting a little loose from Jimmy, but Wade definitely makes the mistake there. And Stewart takes back that position. Going back to Charles here. Let's see what's going on with Charles. Marshall up to 11th place now. Oh, it gets a little wheel hopping. Ed Boyles in the 38 coming through the S's here. Actually, that wasn't the S's. I lied. That was the last corners there coming to the last corner. Oh, gets it sideways. Ed loses it. So Ken is going to take over that spot for 8th place now. That's 8th and 9th right there. Joshua Battles and Timothy Wortman right here for 5th and 6th place. With 34 laps to go. Jared Michon right now in second, and it's 9:53. Are we gonna see him leave in the next 2 minutes? Or if he was just playing a joke on us. You can see he's getting around some lap traffic. That's gonna be the number five of Jimmy, currently one lap down in last place. I go, Kenny. Ken would be faster if his car was Pepsi instead of Coke. I go, Kenny, do you not like Coke? Oh. You got the, I think, was that Ollie's? Ollie's? What is that? Ollie's Bargain Outlet. No, Coke bad. Oh, yeah, I don't mind. I'm not that picky. I tell you what, though, I did not like is, you know, when they you ask for a Sprite and you get a Sierra Mist. Oh, that is so disgusting. They say it's alike, but it is not alike. It is not similar. watching Zach going around the last corner there. I believe I've seen some smoke go around. I think he's going to be catching up to Charles here in just a moment. Let's ride on board in cockpit view with Zach lingering, and let's go ride on board for about a lap here. With some lap traffic in the coming up here in just a minute. You see the double O, and I believe the 28 of Stewart right in front. You see the double O goes, let's goes a little wide to let Zach lingering by, and now he gets on the gas there. Now he's going to try to catch up to Stewart here. So we got two cars right now. One lap down for 14th and 15th. Going to be trying to catch up to 13th place car here, Stewart. So now we got three cars. One lap down. You have to drink all diets, Diet Pepsi, Mountain Dew, or Dr. Pepper. I never had I've had Mountain Dew, but never had Diet Dr. Pepper. That, definitely, we don't mind Sprite around here in our house, because it's, I'm not sure if a Sprite is just a Michigan thing, or if it's all around, but it's, no caffeine at all in it. It's just basically all you have is the bubbles in it, in a way, kind of like a lime soda in a, kind of in a similar aspect. So Tommy Kelly right now 7.0 away from the leader. Jared Wilshon still holding that second gap from Zach Lingren. Now you can see them getting around the number three of Pete Woodrum. So right now, 12th place, one lap down, so we got 11 drivers on the lead lap. No caffeine? Sprite? I don't believe it has caffeine. I'll have to look at the bottle. Or the can, I should say, but... the wife definitely, because when she drinks caffeine, it gives her, like, sometimes it gives her headaches and things like that, so... Sprite is kind of a good... she used to drink Diet Pepsi, but she now drinking more of Sprite. And she definitely helps. Watching on board now with Preston, the Motorcraft, coming towards the line. So we got 30 laps to go here tonight. Off track a little bit, two tracking, gets it back rolling though. Oh, I understand now. I thought maybe because of belly, is that belly gas or belief? Belly. Uncle Kenny, I'm lost on your last word. I'm not very smart though. Let's see what else is going on here. So it looks like Ed Boyles right now, I think he is off track. Wade Palmer right now coming to turn one. Oh, getting a little loosey-goosey. Bud Light going off track, going into that dirty, dirty grass. Zach Lingering now get around. Jared Wishon getting around now. Oh, please. Fat finger. Oh, well, sometimes, I'm not sure if you're on your computer, but my cell phone, I hate sometimes the cell phones. You try to type, and I'll hit two different letters at the same time. I told everybody, like, we have a group chat with all the guys that we race together at times, and I just tell him, don't worry about my texting or my messages. My messages kind of... I think they learned so far that misspelled words is common for me. One thing is because I'm not very smart with English, and two, my fingers like to type a little bit faster than what I my brain goes. Oh, the 22 is around. So 22 trying to hold on to it now, getting himself back going. Currently in sixth place. He is 50 seconds back from the leader. Ken Rain now in seventh, 53 seconds now. So we currently have, right this moment, 9 drivers on the lead lap. Wade Palmer is going to be the first one lap down. Pete Woodruff, Marshall Layton, Charles Stevens, Stuart Ovens, and Jimmy Epshire are all one lap down. The 38 of Ed right now, just seeing where he's at. They're currently trying to stay on the lead lap. Let's see where he is going into that last corner. Where right now Zach, I believe, is in the S's. So he's definitely got a little gap between that. So he's got a little bit of a cushion. So Jared Rashad's going to stay out. He looks like it's past 10 o'clock and 10:02, so he's not going to go to that official race at Talladega. I tried auto-type, but it was the worst. And trying to understand my speech, I would type weird words. I think it was developed on Pluto. Oh, yes. Or sometimes you put down, like, oh, I can't even think of an example. But you'd be, like, one letter off, and then it auto-correct you, and it'd be a whole different topic. Like, you'd say pineapple. And you're trying to put down the E and auto correction, it would be talking about horses or something. Like, how is this even close to what I'm trying to even type? So sometimes I turned my auto thing off, and my wife tried to text on my phone, and she goes, "Why do you have this thing off?" Well, you see, I'm not the smartest guy, first of all. Second of all, I hate it. Oh, Zach's got some company trying to... Ooh, that was close. Now Jared Rashad's going to be trying to catch up to... I think that was the number 5 of Jimmy going off track. Oh, very close. Ooh, doggy. Keeping it going, though. Kind of feels like we're having a flying drone following right now. The 96 of Jared kind of just on board with them, seeing the whole car. You can see sparks just a flying, basically that front end goes up in the air a little bit, that front right is how the setups are. And now you can see let's go up to Zach Lingard. Zach's trying to catch up to, I believe that's going to be Ken in the number 43. No, that's going to be the 75 of Wade Palmer. Tommy Kelly right now on board of that AC spark plug, that Pontiac. On board with now Timothy. 26 laps to go. At 22, Mr. Miller here in 6th place. Right now we got 7 drivers on lead lap. You can see Ken right now, they'll be the last one on the lead lap. But Ed goes down pit road. Wade Palmer and Stewart also went down pit road. So we got some strategies now starting to come in. So I believe They've been out there for 16 laps. That's about 16, 17-ish is when drivers are probably going to start coming in. But I could be wrong, because these guys up here know how to make it happen. So right now, Tommy is 18.1 seconds back. Jared's holding back 2.2. Right now, watching the number 11, Joshua Battles. I'm kind of waiting to see who's going to be the first one going to the drag strip after here. With 25 laps to go. I believe I've seen their... Wade Palmer slowed down. I believe he may have went off track there for a moment. Coming to towards the line here, 24 laps to go. You can see, oh, the 75 getting a little wide. Oh, he's going around. And he is all the way down there. Into the fence he is. That's going to put him back to pit road. Now Zach Linger back in the essence here. Currently still in first. His teammate right behind him still, 2.5 seconds back at this moment of time. Definitely doing a great job keeping it on track, trying to hold on to it. You can see Tommy now into the S's. That's how far, 22 seconds back. Preston right now coming into the S's. You see they're a little bit of front right damage though. You can see Miller right now in the 22. You can see how much tire wear is getting it on the track now. Uncle Kenny, was that too hot to Robbie stream, or was that something I forgot what I asked? Watching here, Marshall, ninth place. He's just got to catch up to Joshua. And Joshua right now currently also one lap down. See, he comes across the line, and Joshua right now, I think he's leaving one or two. Oh, he's actually going down the hill. So he's got a little bit of a gap in between him and Marshall. Oh, too hot trying to enter turn. I gotcha. I got lost there. Very easy for me to do. So iRacing came out with a new update today. Yeah, actually you can see a couple, I think it was the last update, not this time, but the other one. You can actually see some faces now these drivers have. You can, instead of the full face helmet. I got lost going to the bathroom. Oh, Uncle Kenny. That's not good, Uncle Kenny. You know, you could make it easier though. You could take your stuff to the bathroom. You could sit there. Makes it easy. If your lady comes, say, yeah, I'm doing my business. We're all good. right now. Ken still on the lead lap here in the 43. Oh, going a little wide though. So we have right now, it looks like the 22 in pit road. So is the number 9. It looks like Ed Boyles, Timothy Wortman, and Pete Woodrum also, they already been down pit road. The front leaders, I didn't make a mistake. I was completely wrong. They already been out there now 19 laps. There he goes. Zach Linger now going down pit road, your race leader. Now Jared Wishon's going to stay out and try to lead a lap. Just 21 laps to go here tonight. We have completed 20, so we're almost halfway here. All I would have to do is cut a hole in the wall and put up a shelf. There you go. That would be perfect. Then, you know, maybe cut another hole. You could put, a little fridge in there, just a little one. You can have something to drink. If you want a couple snacks, put on top of the refrigerator. You'd be perfect. Be able to watch streams and be all decent. You just have to have the comfy toilet seat, though. You can't have the hard ones. So Preston up to second. Zach comes back out of pit road. And now he is currently in third. 40 seconds back from the leader. Tommy Kelly also now down pit road for fourth place. No food or drink in the bathroom. I would never leave. Oh. Well, if you did that, anybody ask where you were, just, you know, all you have to say, I'm in the bathroom. Everybody would know where you're at now. No food or drink. Oh. But you could put, like, you could have it all decked out there. Maybe have some lights up, you know, put, like, not Christmas lights, but little hanging lights in there to kind of make it, you know, kind of snazzy inside. You'd have a shower in there you wouldn't have to worry about. Don't worry about have to, you know, if you worried if you were stinking or not. You just have the shower right there, too. You'd be golden. So let's see, Jared Wishon in pit road, but where I'm trying to see where Zach is. Here he is, coming up the hill, and there's where Jared Wishon is. Fill up the empty without moving much. Exactly. Oh, I was reading, and then the last message just popped up. There you go. Oh, what's going on in front? I believe somebody went off track there. With 20 laps to go, Zach's still your leader. Jared Wishon, but still sticking with him behind him. So it looks like now with everything turned around, it looks like Joshua Battle's now in pit road, but we got six drivers on the lead lap. The 22 will be the last one on the lead lap. Ken will be the first one lap down. Tommy Kelly, 24 seconds back. You see coming to the line now. But Tommy Kelly put down the fastest lap out there, 120.140. Where Zach's is a 120.327. So Tommy Kelly is cruising out there. Let's go back to Timothy Wortman right now in the 83, currently in fourth place, 34 seconds back. Preston right now. He is in fifth place. You're running your top five, 43 seconds back. Go up to the 22. In sixth place, you can see coming across the line where Zach Lindgren right now is coming to the line. So you can see Zach's trying to catch up to sixth to put sixth place one lap down. Couple other drivers coming out of pit road. It's getting a little crazy up here right now. Going up the little hill here, getting ready to go down the hill now here tonight. You can see the number five, Jimmy, letting the leaders go by. Actually, nope, that was the number three. I lied, that's not Jimmy, that was Pete Woodrum. Oh, look at that. Jared has closed the gap on Zach Lindgren right in that last corner. Have they figured, has he figured a way to catch up to Zach? With traffic in the way too, that also helped. The five goes over. That was Jimmy there, letting the leaders by. Come to the last corner here. Gonna be coming to 17 laps to go. Look at the different lines. Zach getting onto the yellow blue, basically in the way a turtle. Up here in the blimp view of the night. So Wade Palmer is off track now in the number 75. We seen that earlier when he was going into the audience. All right, let's get a little bit closer on a couple of these. Let's see what's going on over here. Getting ready to come into the S's for your leaders here. Coming up to Marshall Layton right now. Currently one lap down in ninth place. Just going to be trying to put him two laps down. Oh, Marshall. Believe he went off track there. Right in front of the leaders. You can see him now getting back going. There you go. Racing into that last corner once again. Coming to 16 laps to go. Zach Lindgren dominating here so far tonight. So I'll pull up real quick with that last pit strategy about 4 to 5 laps ago. This is what it looked like. Zach Linger 21.40, where Jared was a 22. Kelly was also a 22. Look at Timothy, a 20-second stop there. Preston was also a 22nd. Miller right now was also a 22. You can see it looks like Ed Boyles is in pit row 24 seconds now with his stop of the night. He is currently in 12th place, two laps down. And so is the number five. He's also down pit road. So that's what it looked like out the race off pit road and how long they were in there for. They're catching up to the 22 here. That's going to be Mr. Miller. He's going to drop down, try to get it out of the way to let them by. But impressive run for the top two right now. They're still sticking with each other. Jared's 0.7 seconds away. So tomorrow night, though, if you want to see some more racing, the FSM Custom Truck Series is going to be live tomorrow night. We're going to be live at 8:15 p.m. Eastern Time. If you want to see some crazy trucks going around at Talladega, stay tuned because that's going to be one heck of a race. But I also may not either have Dustin Kaliba in the booth with me, or I may have Zach Lingren in the booth with me. I asked one of them, and they may hop up there with me and give me some company tomorrow night. Uncle Kenny, hard to pass on a road course. It definitely is. I don't even know how to make a pass here, to be honest. I would say the only way I would try to pass is boot, scoot, and buggy. But we've seen these two battle before, though, at road courses, sticking together. These two know how to do it. But they have had a lot of practice on road courses, too, doing the 24-hour at Daytona and doing other Le Mans and things like that for Elite Motorsports. Uncle Kenny, yeah, I'm trying to actually. Oh, we can see. I believe that was the number three off track now, Pete Woodrum. I'm trying to get Zach up here in the booth more often. I told him, you know what you could do is get up here on Sunday nights with me and give me some company, or give on Monday nights. Always a blast to have Zach up here. Always cracks me up, and definitely we always have a good time. But also been talking to Spence too, trying to get see if Spence wants to do some broadcasting. So Tommy Kelly right now 28 seconds back in third place. Looks like right now we only got five drivers now on the lead lap. Preston's gonna be the last one on the lead lap here. Jared has fallen back from Zach though. Now it's 1.3 second gap with 13 laps to go. Okay, hopefully next season I hope to be racing Zach. Yeah, definitely. That'd be cool to see you out there racing. Have you got in the lobby with him yet and raced with him, Uncle Kenny? Did like a private practice or anything? I can get my C license anytime. That is, I can't believe how fast you're getting up there, Uncle Kenny. That is amazing. See, it's getting a little bit better now after getting out of that rookie class. Now I have to deal with, there's still idiots out there, but not as bad. See, now he's just watching in the gyro cam. There's not much of curves here where it messes with the gyro cam, but it's always fun, different view. He's catching up here to, I believe, Stewart. So right now they're running about a 1:21 around the lap of this track. They're really only a second difference from their fastest lap. But my question is, are we going to see one more? One more race will be probably be moved up to next race. Only need a couple of points to break 4.0. That is amazing. Uncle Kenny, that is incredible. I'm so happy for you. It's definitely difficult, but the accomplishments is amazing. I gotta get work on my road course license. That's what I need to do. I got my oval up to an A class, but I need to work on my rating, and I need to get my road, and I think my dirt and my road's at a D license right now. I want to get them up to at least a C. I want to get the road up to a C so I can actually join Elite Motorsports on the 24 hours road race in there. So just 11 laps to go. You can see the tires are just a glowing. Just 11 laps to go. Now just 10 laps to go. Jared Rashawn still trying to catch up. He's 2.1 seconds away from Zach Lindgren. Tommy Kelly, 32.7 seconds in third. Preston right now is 55 seconds back. That's four drivers now on the lead lap. It'll be a bit before I try road courses. Yeah, I never really cared for it at first, but after getting the hang of it, it's not too bad. We got Ed Boyles off track now, so we got two drivers now off track. Nine laps now. Let's see. Look at trying to do some math here. If they're gonna have to come in, we seen them go over 19 laps, and that's about is when they went in tops 20. And they've been out there right now. Zach's been out there for 12 laps. They got 9 laps to go. I do believe they're gonna have to come in one more time, but I could be wrong. I have to train my brain to remember speeds for each turn. That's my biggest issue I think I ran into, is trying to remember the track. You know, Sonoma and Watkins Glen I kind of knew because of watching it on television. But, you know, when you go to, I can't even think of the other tracks, to be honest. But I couldn't remember, you know, where the corners were, where to get onto the brake, you know, when to downshift. It was a whole different ball game of trying to figure it out. That's probably my most difficult. Uncle Kenny, have you done any dirt racing yet? Dirt racing? Have you done any of the ovals on dirt? That's interesting. That's training your brain that if you want to turn right, you turn left. With 8 laps to go here. Zach Lindgren looking on fire here tonight. Jared Rashawn definitely looking really well in that sheathunderwear.com 96. Let's see if he can be able to turn this into a win for himself. Not yet. Yeah, give it a shot. It's different. I don't know why this decided to pop up on me. I do apologize. What the heck? There we go. Getting get rid of that. Gotta love iRacing. Pop it up on you. So you can see Jared Marchand getting around the number five there. Zach Legren coming across the line now, bringing it to seven laps to go. So give you a little bit of insight on the points here about this season. Tommy Kelly right now with six wins as your leader. Joshua Battles in second, Jason Renauden in third. We got Pete Woodrum's in fourth, Brandon Hinton in fifth, Cannon's in sixth, Stuart Evans in seventh. Wade Palmer is in 8th. I'm trying to see Jaron Hazen with 3 wins this season, currently in 16th place. So it's a little bit different. I thought that was me, LOL. No, that was me. With iRacing doing that beta thing, the beta decided to poke up and I had it turned off, so I'm not sure why it did that. I tell you, I don't really care for the beta though. I'm more of the website type of guy. So Zach going into the first corners here with 6 laps to go. Can he hold it off for 6 more of them? We got 4 drivers still on the lead lap. Let's see where Preston is right now. He's, I believe, coming to the yeses here. Let's see what's going on back in the back, though. I do believe we got somebody going down pit road. That's going to be Marshall. Pete Woodrum sitting in pit road now for 13th place. So a lot of drivers in the back, though, have went down pit road. Like Marshall, looks like 3 laps ago on the number 22, Mr. Miller went down pit road. Looks like Timothy Wartman 5 laps ago went down pit road. They switched to the beta just before I started, so I was forced into it before seeing the old way. Oh man, the old way I liked it, just basically the website, not having to use the beta, but I guess in a way it definitely helps you. Not, you know, you're not used to how the old way looks, so I think that would be definitely a lot easier. With 5 laps to go, though. Zach and the S is coming ready to bring it to 4 laps to go. Jared 2.5 seconds back from the leader. So the closest battle right now for the top 2. Still sticking together. Very impressive how they could just hold on to these cars. Oop. There we go. Look at Marshall sitting in pit road right now with a little bit of damage. Zach Lagerin still coming ready to go into the S's. Coming to three laps to go this time by. He's definitely looking good. See, Preston now coming to the finish line here, where Zach Lindgren is going into the last corner. So he is closing into fourth place, trying to bring it to the three drivers on the lead lap. Mama lingered out there. How you doing out there tonight? Good to see ya. Just perfect timing to join on board. Zach Lingren right now, your leader, with three laps to go. Jared Rashawn's 2.3 seconds back. I'm doing pretty good. Doing pretty well. Zach coming to the last corner here, gonna be coming to the line with two laps to go. All he has to do this two more laps and not make a mistake. Coming to the line now. Looks like he's got some traffic in front of him. I believe that's going to be Stewart in the 28 and the 00 of Charles. But give a shout out to Charles there for a while. He was leading the back. Now he's up to ninth place in the top 10. Jared Wishon trying to catch up to Zach. He's now dropped it to 2.8 seconds with some lap traffic coming involved. You missed it. Zach did the farmers only. Yep. Mama Lingard, when the broadcast is over, I don't think you can rewind it. No, I don't believe, but once the broadcast is over, you got to go. It's going to be during practice. I pulled Zach up. It was actually right kind of in the qualifying time, and you gotta listen into that. Robbie was there helping us out, trying to get Zach to do it. All right, coming out of the last corner, going to be bringing it to one lap to go, bringing that white flag out here tonight. Hello, my boy. I'm also, Mama Linger, I'm trying to get him to get in the booth with me tomorrow night. It's either him or Dustin Kleba might get in. I actually got to message him, see if he's able to, but trying to get Zach to be back in the booth with me. He was in the booth with me, what was it, Sunday? I can't remember what day it was. I think it was Sunday. 00, Zach. 00 gets onto that corner there and almost makes contact with the 00, but here he goes. On this last lap, Jared Rashawn, 1.6 seconds. He's closed it in just a little bit. Coming to the yeses. Sunday he wrecked. Yeah, it was Sunday, because I remember after he wrecked, it was on lap one, he got involved in something and hopped up there. I had a lot of fun with Zach up here. Basically, us goofing off and having fun while doing it. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, your race winner here tonight. Jared gets it sideways. Your race winner here tonight at Sonoma is going to go to Zach Lindgren. And Jared Wishon in second. Tommy Kelly's going to bring home your third place finish. What a night for these guys. And give a shout out to everybody out here tonight. So drivers are still trying to get around and get caught up, because right now it's showing we have 2 second place finishers here. That's what my scoreboard is trying to show, I guess. So while we're doing that, we're going to pull these drivers down real quick and have a chat with them. Definitely was a great race for sure. So let's see if Zach Lindgren's going to do the burnouts here tonight. Yeah, Jared Wishon and Tommy Kelly says, I believe he's coming across the line now. A shit update. There we go. Now into third. Oop, I don't want that there. There he is in the, it looks like the parking lot, burning it out here for the night. So great job by Zach Lingard, but we're going to pause it here. I believe he's done. So we're going to pause it there and do our post-race show. Let's give a shout out though to Lynchburg T-Shirt Company, being the sponsor of No Lift Esports Network. Head on over to their Facebook page. Give them a like for us. If you want a T-shirt made, all you have to do is say No Lift sent you and get 15% off. Alrighty, so our third place finisher here we're going to pull up is going to be Tommy Kelly. Let's see how he is feeling. Got the pole, and he led one lap, but finished third. Let's see how he's doing. Hey, Tommy, this is Brandon No Lift. You got a copy?
Yes, sir. I got you.
Alrighty, bud. You got the pole here tonight. You led a lap and able to bring it home third. How you feeling?
I'm a little bit disappointed, but, you know, can't be too terribly disappointed with another good run. And being able to literally coast all the way to the finish line from entry to the hairpin over there. Pretty lucky to come home third.
Definitely. That was a very impressive run. You know, it's a tricky track, and you're able to keep it on as best as you can. And, man, do you think would there be anything different you would have tried to done if you could redo this?
I might have done something different in practice and whatnot leading up to it, but in the race, I think I did about all I could do.
Alrighty, well, buddy, congrats on the third place, and, you know, anybody out there, you want to give a shout-out here tonight?
Yeah, I want to thank my grandparents, my mom, my dad, and Marshall for hosting the league, and everyone that makes this happen.
Alrighty, well, buddy, have a great rest of the week. We'll see you next week.
Thank you, man.
Yeah, thank you. What channel did I pull you again?
RCR.
Thank you. Alrighty, there is Tommy. I keep forgetting what channel. So let's pull up our second place finisher here and see if he's got a copy. Jared Wishon. Let's see what's going on with him. Hey, Jared, you got a copy?
I gotcha.
Alrighty, buddy. Well, you're at 10 o'clock, so a little late.
I lost track of time there, and then I realized it was like 10:01.
Well, you know, you and Zach love to battle each other at road courses, and man, you guys still, you know, you're only 1.8 second away from him, and, you know, it was very close how the pit strategy happened. They were, you guys coming out with each other like that was very cool to see, but man, what a night for you, able to bring home second place, and you led 2 laps.
We had a great car. Me and Zach was pretty even, and I know he better send the 28 a Christmas card, because I think that's the reason he won the race, because the 28 let him by, and then he slammed the brakes in front of me, and I lost like 2 seconds. So that was unfortunate, but congrats to Zach on the win. We definitely were pretty even, but it would have been nice to have a shot at it and not have a lap car ruin it.
Well, buddy, I just want to wish you luck next week. Let's see if you can get your win next week. But overall, not a bad night for Elite Motorsports.
It's great, always great to finish 1-2. And unfortunately, Jaron and Devin weren't here tonight. But glad if one of us was able to get the win.
Well, I know you got a couple shout-outs here tonight you want to give.
She for being on the car. Unfortunately, we come home one spot short tonight for them. But appreciate their support, and thank you for broadcasting.
Most definitely. Well, buddy, we'll see you next week. Take care of yourself, and have a good night. All right, Jared Wishon. Next up, though, Zach Lingering. Let's see how he's feeling. Zach, this is Brandon. Got a copy?
Yeah, buddy, I got
you. All righty, well, look at you bringing home the win. You also led 37 laps. What a night for you.
Yeah, that was a hectic race, man. It was a lot more hectic than what I would have thought it was. It was a fun race with how slidey these things were.
Well, you're able to bring the Kermit Frog, you know, ritual
oh,
like you do.
No,
I'm just saying you're able to do it because, you know, usually it's, you know, one of those victory love to do it. And, man, look at you. I think we need to do this every practice.
Every practice?
Yeah, and pull you up,
man. You're asking for a lot, man.
Well, not bad night for you. You dominated the night. You know, overall, how did you feel out there?
We felt pretty good, like I said. It was just a really hectic night. Some drivers, you know, were doing a really good job of keeping it on track, keeping it clean. Really, all the drivers kept it really clean tonight. Some drivers had a handle on this track more than others, and we were passing a few lap cars there, and it's really tough at this track to pass a car as even as you, and when you come up on a slow car in any part of the track, it's really tough to get around them. So, besides that, you know, it was a really good race. It was just navigating the traffic was a bit tough. The car wanted to slide a lot. There was a few times I almost lost it. I was lucky I was able to regain it before it completely went around. Jared was so even with me. I dominate him in a few sections of the track, and he would completely obliterate me in the other sections of the track. We were constantly even right on top of each other. There's a few times where I'd gain time on him and he'd gain time on me. So one little slip up and it was Jared's. He was fast all night. So I knew we just had to stay consistent, keep consistent lap times coming, make sure I managed the gap between me and him so I didn't give him the opportunity to take the lead on me.
Definitely. Well, looking back at the chat real quick, you're Mama's out there tonight, yeah, boy. And then Uncle Kenny says, Robbie says, congrats, Zach.
Tell him I said thanks, Uncle Kenny. Thank you, guys. Thank you, guys, for the support. I love it. Love it from the family.
Definitely. Well, buddy, anybody out there you want to give a shout-out here tonight?
And give a shout-out to NASCAR Diecast fans for being on the car. If you ever need to stay up to date with any of your diecast needs, go to NASCAR Diecast fans on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. They'll keep you up to date with everything that's being produced. Go through Plan B Sales. You use code DFANS at checkout for free shipping anywhere in the U.S. You up here in the booth, Brandon, doing what you do. I know it's not easy doing it up here all alone, especially on a road course. So we appreciate you doing what you do up here. The league admins for putting it on. Everyone in the league, really respectful drivers. They're really fun guys to race around. Everyone back at home watching, hopefully we put on a good show for you. My teammates over at Elite Motorsports for putting me in a car, trusting me to run their stuff, so a huge shout out to them. Jared tonight, he gave me the biggest battle tonight, so I can't thank him more. The brave men and women overseas defending us, allowing me to sit here for a few hours, race for just a little bit, so a huge shout out to them as well.
Definitely. And, you know, like you were saying about the support, and I have to give a shout out to the fans out there, and, you know, especially your family out there, especially Uncle Kenny. I have to give the biggest shout out to Uncle Kenny. Uncle Kenny comes out and gives, you know, keeps me company, especially being at Sonoma. Like you said, I'll be honest. The broadcasting road courses is not my favorite thing to do at all. I have to admit. But, you know, Uncle Kenny out there keeping me company in the chat, and definitely love it. You know, and he did say, be sure, or I'm sure Robbie would like to see everyone over there where he is. Legends are running, so maybe we'll, right after this, we'll stop by and see what's going on with Robbie.
Or give them a quick show. Yeah, maybe we can go over there and see what's going on with Robbie.
Definitely. Well, Zach, I'm just going to keep you here just to get, you know, so I don't have to do more work. But I hope everybody has a great rest of the night. We appreciate everybody tuning in. Want to see some more trucks take on track at Talladega, some restrictor plates. FSM Custom Trucks will be live at 8:15 p.m. Eastern tomorrow night. So stay tuned. Have a great night, and we'll see y'all tomorrow.